Hello, this is Kevin, and today we're going to talk about Sage SQL estimating using a product though called Microsoft Power BI to get into some more advanced reporting than what we've ever done before. Here's kind of an example of what you could do. What if you could pull up a list of all the estimates that you've been awarded? So this is a little summary of some data I've put together, basically showing me from, 2014, all the different years of where we're at. So in this case here, this chart's basically showing me each estimator and how much basically each estimator's been awarded in a given year. Up at the top of it, it actually has the total contract amount of all the years. How many contracts have we been awarded in those years? The smallest one's been about 13K, then average 1.2 million, or maybe the maximum contract was $20 million job. As we look through here then, this is just showing it by sectors, so different project classes. So you can flag your estimates and keep track of what types of projects they are. So there again, in 2019, maybe I could tell the difference in retail stores versus office space versus hotels. This one's the same thing, just organized a little bit different. This is called a tree map, different years, where it kind of shows what's bigger and bigger blocks and things like that, and just more of a visual effect, a little bit different. So there again, I can kind of hover over something and tell, and that year we did so many schools. Where are we doing most of our work? There again, color-coded of, I think I've got this set up where green is the higher dollars versus lower dollars. And then a list of all the projects that fall into this conditions at the moment. Now, what makes these reports really brilliant is they all interact with each other. If I wanted to know how much I've estimated for a given year, I can click on myself. That will actually show that Missouri disappeared. All the states that I've actually been awarded any contracts so far is just in those two states. There's my new dollar amount. So $31 million, 12 contracts, minimum, maximum, same type of thing. Over here, you'll kind of notice that my charts have started to break out, that I didn't have any grocery stores, I didn't have any road work, but in my case, I had some hotels, retail stores, schools, hospitals, and so forth. And then down here gives me a list of what those projects actually are. So if I go back to what's something that was pretty small, let's say office space I want to focus on. So office space there again will show me what state. So just Kansas work was the only place that we had any office work. Since I picked it over here and not by estimator, it's went back and opened up all my estimators. So there I could kind of see myself and Brett's done some estimates and so forth, what we awarded, what the total of them is. So there again, that's what I'm kind of seeing up here. How many, same thing. So it's really kind of ingenious that you can actually have reports that are actually interactive with each other on finding information. So that way, if I click on any of these different charts, if I click on a chart, it'll release a filter and go back to all of them. What have I done in Iowa? Same type of thing. So there I could kind of tell at a glance of what I've done in Iowa. So, just very, very small spots there in the relationship of it. Or here it's a little bit easier to see that I could tell, I've had some retail stores here, I've had some retail stores there. So it looks like, retail stores is what we're doing more. Here's maybe my detailed list of them if I've wanted them. Those type of things. So it's just a real nice way that I can actually get information in different aspects. So what do you think? Is that something that's kind of useful? What do you think would be more beneficial? Please make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and then also make some comments. Give me an idea of what else would actually be beneficial to your company to manage over your estimating department.